Bibles, turn with us to Galatians chapter 6. Galatians chapter 6. As you know, our theme for 2018 is the church that sows and reaps the blessings of God. That is our theme for 2018, the church that sows and reaps the blessings of God. Now, in Galatians chapter 6, can we stand together in the house of the Lord? Galatians chapter 6. Starting at verse 1, Galatians chapter 6. In Galatians chapter 6, our new members are those new to Christ. It's in the New Testament. The letter that Paul wrote to the church is in Galatia. In Galatians chapter 6, it reads, "Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass," I'm reading from the New King James Version, "you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself lest you also be tempted.
All right, come on now.
Bear one another's burdens."
That's right.
"And so fulfill the law of Christ. But if anyone thinks himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceives himself. But let each one examine his own work, and then he will have rejoicing in himself alone, and not in another. For each one shall bear his own load. Let him who is taught the word share in all good things with him who teaches. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. But whatsoever a man sows, that he will also reap. But he who sows to the flesh will of the flesh reap corruption. But he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. Let us not grow weary in well doing. For in due season we will reap if we do not lose heart. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all, especially to those who are of the household of faith." Turn your neighbor and say, "Neighbor, are you ready for this?" You may be seated. Ready for this. Amen. Are you ready for this? In 2018, God has given our church a challenge. A challenge of knowing that he wants us to be a church that knows how to sow and how to reap the blessings of God. How many of us are ready, really ready, to reap the blessings of God? If you're ready to reap the blessings of God, there must be a time in your life on a consistent basis where you are sowing the right seed. For whatever a man or woman sows, the Bible declares that they shall reap what they sow. 2018, Paul is showing us in this word of God, he was challenging the churches in Galatia to change. To know that if they were going to be the people God wanted them to be, they had to change. And guess what? There are two powerful words that can determine whether or not we change or not, or stay the same. And those words are deceived and believe. If we are going to reap the blessings of God and experience the power of God in 2018, we got to make sure we do not let the devil deceive us. The word deceives means that the devil wants to leave the wrong impression on your mind. The devil wants not only to deceive us, not leave the wrong impression on our mind, but the devil wants to get an advantage over your life. In other words, the devil wants to get an upper hand on your life, to stop you from reaching the goals and objectives that God has designed for you in 2018. You gotta tell that devil, "I don't care what your plans are, what your plots are, but you are not gonna deceive me and stop me from getting what God has in store for me." As leaders and members, we gotta understand, we cannot let the deceiver and the deceiver control our minds and our hearts. We gotta say to the devil, "Not this year. You may have messed me up last year, but not this year." and we allow the power of God in us to make us resist the enemy who seeks to deceive us, guess what? It will change our lives. Paul is writing to the churches in Galatia because something happened. Paul had went there and preached the word and proclaimed the word. Then after a while, when Paul left, all of a sudden the enemy came in and deceived these people and made them start preaching another gospel instead of the true gospel of Jesus Christ. See, the gospel is about the good news of Jesus. How he came into this world and died for the sins of the world. We might have life and have it more abundantly because of Jesus. Suffering and death and burial and resurrection. That's good news for all of us because without Jesus, we would not have salvation. Paul came in preaching some good news. No matter who you are and what you've done, if you repent of your sins, give your life to Jesus, he will save you today. That's some good news. But they allowed the deceivers to come in and they changed the gospel from good news to bad news. The Bible says they perverted the gospel. That word pervert means to alter it. Don't you know the devil is always trying to alter or change what God put in place? Every time God has made you away and put you in a place of suffering, here comes the devil and his deceivers trying to alter or change what thus said the Lord. Even in 2018, when you reach about, you don't watch it. That devil will try to deceive you. He'll try to change the truth into a lie. But you gotta say, devil, I am not going to let you pervert me, alter me, change me for the wrong reason. I am who God said I am. Forget this. How does the devil try to deceive us? That's a good question. Know what he'll do? He'll try to trick you. Gene Davis said, don't let him trick you. See, you think you know some tricks. That devil knows some tricks, yeah.
Yes, he does.
You see, some people specialize in trickology, but that devil knows how to trick you with a treat. You hear me? Sometimes you'll put a treat out there and try to trick you with a treat, but guess what? He will destroy you. How will he try to deceive you? He'll try to trick you. Then he'll turn around and he'll try to trick you. Look at 2018. That devil is going to try to tempt you to do what you know is not right. That's the devil. No, not in 2018. You may have messed me up in 2017, but not in 2018. I'm not going to let you trick me and then turn around and tempt me. Yeah, he's all right to be tempted, but don't fall into the temptation. The devil not only will try to trick you and tempt you, but guess what? The devil will try to trap you. Jim Neal said the devil got some traps set for you. You don't avoid those traps. You got to walk with God. You got to spend time in prayer, seeking God's face, calling on God's name, because the devil always has some traps out there set for you. I don't know where he tempt you and trap you, but guess what? He want to twist you. Don't you know the devil want to turn you and twist you in all kind of directions? Guess what? He want to make your life uncomfortable because guess what? He specializes in trying to twist you, but thank God, God has power to untwist whatever the devil has twisted up. And some minds have gotten twisted. Some hearts have gotten twisted, but God is saying in 2018, don't let the devil twist you. There was a dance you used to dance called the twist. Y'all remember the twist? I'm not doing that twist. So move your hips from side. Look what the devil will do. He'll throw you from side to side. You'll keep your soul off balance. You're looking going right or going left. The devil loves to twist you. But guess what? The devil only will try to trick you, tempt you, trap you, twist you, but he'll try to tear you. The devil is going to try in 2018 to try to tear you and rip you and separate you from the people you love and care about. He doesn't care about you, but he will tear you to pieces. He'll rip you and destroy what God has given you. The devil will trick you, tempt you, trap you, twist you. Guess what? The devil will trouble you. Don't you know the devil doesn't like it when you have peace in your house? The devil doesn't like you operating the peace of God, but some way, somehow, he's going to use somebody to say something and do something to cause trouble.
some of you.
He also tried to trade skin in you. He wants to change your appearance. Don't you know there are some people you went to school with? You look, they look one way. But if you see them now, you say, what happened to you? Life was rough. Life brought about change. All this world looked like an idiot. No, why? Because they allowed the devil to transfigure them. The devil don't want you smiling, looking good. He wants you looking broke down, no good. Nobody cares about you. He want to change the way you look and present yourself. See, are you ready for this? If we're going to sow and reap the best of God, we cannot be deceived. We cannot let the devil trick us and lie to us and lead us down the wrong path. But God said, don't be deceived. But God is saying to us, you got to believe. Tell your neighbor, you got to believe. Deception will bring us down, but belief will bring us up. Yes. To believe means I am going to have faith in God. I am going to trust in God. I'm going to depend on God. In 2018, my faith, my hope, my love is all wrapped up in the hands of God. Paul said to these churches, I don't know what happened to you. What caused you to turn away from God? Don't you know the devil loves to see the people of God who walked with God at one time turn away from God? What will make you turn away from God? What will make me turn away from God? We must be deceived in order to turn away from God and go into another direction, because God does not lead us down the wrong path. Paul is saying to this church, you need to change. These churches, you have been deceived. And see, when the church get deceived, the world is in trouble. When we as God's people become deceived, we don't know right from left and wrong from right, the world is going to be in worse trouble than you ever saw before in your life. But Paul did something in chapter 1. Paul, let me tell y'all something. Let me tell you my testimony. You see, in 2018, stop telling me about your dad's testimony. Your mother's one. You ought to have a testimony for yourself. Oh, yeah. You don't even tell somebody. Let me tell you what the Lord has done for me. Let me tell you how God has changed my life. You got to know God for yourself. Paul said, I used to be deceived. I used to persecute the church. But one day God revealed his son in me and he changed my life. See, if you go turn around, God must reveal himself to you. He must reveal his son to you. And once you have an encounter with God, your life will be changed forever. No matter how the bad you become, you will come to God. You know this thing is really my life now. And as you go, as you bring this thing closer to close, Paul showed us something in that sixth chapter. Of when you begin to believe in God and trust in God, Paul said, I messed up. I did a lot of bad things, but God changed my life. And just like God changed my life because I began to sow good seed, God can change your life too.
Yes,
first of all, he in chapter 6, verse 1, the first thing he says is this: brother, if a man is overtaken in a trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of gentleness, considering yourself lest you also be tempted. Number one, believe that God will restore you when you have fallen. Tell your neighbor, say,
no matter what you do,
you trust in God. He will restore you. Y'all miss y'all shout. Even in 2018, when things get rough and you find yourself down, the Bible said God will restore you. That means in order to be restored, you lost something. And sometimes in life, we lose something. We lose our joy, we lose our hope, we lose money, we lose possession. But guess what? God has the power to restore you. The Lord said something to the church now. He said, now, restore them in a spirit of gentleness. Lord, have mercy. When people fall and they sin and come short, the Bible says to us, we got to treat them with gentleness.
Yes,
not with bitterness, not with anger, not with resistance. But he said, See, as long as it's him, crucify him. Well, once it becomes me, have mercy on me. All right. So you got to make sure that you sow the right seed. Now, you are doing all right now, but you might fall along the way. You may come short along the way, but if you do, remember God has power to restore it. The page talked about his life. How God had to restore you. He had lost some things, but look at what God is using him to do right now. Go to him, but all of us, God want to restore you. The devil want to leave you on the jump pack.
Oh, yes.
2018, you got to believe that God has the power to restore those who are. Because how are you going to go and tell your friends and your neighbors that God can change their life? You got to let them know, look at me, I'm a testimony. God restored me, and God can restore you too. Secondly, believe that God will use others to help you bear your burdens.
Oh, yes,
verse 2 says, bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of God. Oh, don't you know in 2018, you may have some burdens you got to bear?
Yes.
And don't you know it's God who's going to help you and use other people to help you bear your burdens? I don't care how heavy you are. I don't care how low it is that I'm on you now. God said, I got some people in your circle around you that's going to help you bear your burdens. Y'all miss y'all shouting. Whatever you got to go through in 2018, God said you are not going through it by yourself. Because I already assigned somebody to be by your side, to walk with you, to talk with you. They will be by your side. Christians, you got to help one another. Bear their burdens. And then three, you got to believe that God will give you a reason to rejoice. Lord, verses 3 to 5. But if anyone thinks himself to be something, but he is nothing, he deceives himself. If anyone thinks you somebody, you ain't really nothing. You deceive yourself. In the eyes of God, you are nothing but dust that he made. But God is saying, hey, if you think you're somebody, you really nobody. But let each one examine his own work. And then he will have a reason to rejoice. Lord, y'all miss y'all shout. It's important to think right, but then the Bible says, examine your own works. Stop looking at what I've done. Look at what God used you to do. And once you see yourself and see how God has used you, you have a reason to praise God. Is there anybody here that have a reason to thank God for what God has done in your life? All you have to do is look in the mirror. Look what God has done. It's a blessing to be used by God. Many of you that are sitting out there like doing today, God's in your business. No reason to rejoice because you know you are being used by God, and God has used you, and God is blessing you.
Oh, yes.
And fourthly, believe that God will teach you his word.
Yes.
So you can share with us. Yes. Verse 6, let him who is taught the word share in all good things with him who teaches.
Yes.
Don't you know? You got to believe that God will teach you the word. But guess what? You got to be teachable. God cannot teach you and sow his word in you if you're not willing to pick up your Bible and begin to read the word of God and to study the word of God. But God says, I will teach you my word.
Oh, yes, God.
You want to bless your children?
Yes.
Teach them God's word. You want to bless yourself? Teach yourself God's word. But God has people who are anointed to teach the word, and they can help you to grow in God's word. You got to believe that God is will help me to learn his word. Let me tell you something. There's power in God's word. When you face your challenges in 2018, what's going to keep your mind sound and safe on God is the fact that, guess what? You're in his word. You want it to stop taking all them tranquilizers, all that medicine, because sometimes people are so upset and so stressed out, but all they need is some of God's word. Guess what? You got to believe that God will restore you.
Oh, yeah.
Believe that God will use others to help you bear your burdens. Believe that God will give you a reason to rejoice. Believe that God will teach you his word. And then believe that God will bless you to sow the right seed. We had a friend of ours. He had gone into some trouble, man. He found himself in trouble. He had lost his possessions, and he had lost his house, and he was looking for a place to stay. And guess what? This me and this friend of mine began to say, Reverend, so-and-so lost what they had, and they didn't have anywhere to stay, so we paid for them for a week in a hotel, and we paid one week, and then the next week, guess what? Our church paid one week, and then the next week somebody else paid. When they called me, I made one phone call. Call some friends of mine and say, hey, I found somebody in a situation and can you get a place to stay? So he said, Reverend, yes, we'll take care of him for 1 month.
Yes, Lord.
All right.
What was I doing?
I was
sowing some seeds. Because with my wife and I went to the storm eyes and guess what? We lost our house, got flooded, but guess what? We need a place to stay. And for 1 month, these people opened up their doors and allowed us to stay there. And what I did, I went back. Help somebody else. You better sow some seeds. Because you don't know where you may end up. You don't know what you'll be in need of. So therefore, when people are hurting, you better learn to sow some seeds. When things are well, sow some seeds. Let God use you. You have to run to the church. Run to your own pocketbook. Because don't let anybody get your blessing from you. See, you got to learn how to sow some seeds. It says, do not be deceived. God is not mocked. Whatever man sows, they go reap. So in 2018, make sure you sow good seeds. Seeds of love, seeds of hope, seeds of peace. Be kind to other people. Because guess what? All you are doing is being a blessing to yourself and to those around you. Your blessing. They bless your grandchildren.
Oh, yeah.
And Bible said, we talked about Isaac and how Isaac was able to be blessed. And that God said, the reason why I'm blessing you, Isaac, is because your father obeyed me.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Don't you know what you're doing today?
Uh-huh.
Going to impact your children,
yes,
and your grandchildren, yes, and your great grandchildren, because that's why we got to sow the right seed.
Yes.
Believe that God will bless you to sow the right seed, but then 60, believe that God will bless you to reap the good that you sow.
Oh,
yeah. And then in verse 9 it says, let us not grow weary in well doing. But in due season we will reap if we do not lose heart.
My Lord.
Don't you know if you sow the right seed,
yeah,
you're going to reap it.
Sure not.
But sometimes the Bible says, don't get weary.
Yes.
Have you been sowing and working? And it seems like God is not doing anything.
Well,
God is saying, don't you give up.
Uh-huh.
Keep on doing the right thing.
Yes,
keep on standing right there. Because whatever you sow, you're going to end up reaping what you sow. I was ready to reap God's blessing today.
Oh, yes,
but you can't reap what you ain't sow.
Yes,
if you sow corn, you're going to reap corn. Whatever you sow, you're going to reap what you sow. And finally, believe that God will use or give you another opportunity,
yeah,
to do good to others.
Uh-huh.
Then verse 10 says, therefore, as we have opportunity,
yes,
let us do good to all, especially to those who are the household of faith.
Uh-huh.
In 2018, guess what? God is going to use you,
yes, Lord,
and give you another opportunity.
Well.
Turn your neighbor and say, neighbor,
God
gave
me
another chance. See, he knew, he knows what you've done in 2017, but God is saying, I'll give you another opportunity to be used by Almighty God. We don't know when this day be home. We don't know if we're going to live or die. We don't know. But guess what? Thank God he gave you this opportunity, and you got to use it.
you worship.
Yes, he will.
He'll change the way you walk. He'll change the way you talk. He'll change the way you lead. But you must believe that God can do what his word said he can do. There's a story told by Charles Wing about the little engine that could. And it's told that in the railroad yard, there was a heavy train. And this train needed an engine to carry it over a mountain. And the steward in the railroad yard went to one engine and said, "Engine, can you carry this train up on the mountain?" And the engine looked at the train and said, No, that train is too heavy."
Yes,
Lord. Then the conductor of the yard superintendent went to another engine and said to that engine, "Can you carry this train up on the mountain?" He said, No, that train is too heavy for me." But then he went to another brand new train and said, "Little train, can you carry this engine? Can you carry this train engine on the other side?" And the little engine said, "I believe I can." And the Bible said, the story goes on to say, they connected the little engine to the train. And the little engine began to toot-toot down the railroad track. I believe I can. And he went another mile. He said, "I believe I can." And he kept a little further. He said, "I believe I can." As he started to go up the hill, he said, "I believe I can." As he got to the top of the hill, he said, "I believe I can." When he came over the hill, he said, "I knew I could." I want to tell somebody, that little engine that believed it could. God needs some people, some believers in the house that believe that you can make it happen with the power of God. Is there anybody here that believe that God can use you to carry the load, to carry the train, and know that he's God? Tell your neighbor, I believe I can. With God's help, you can do it. You can make it. You can fake it. You can believe. God will. I said, God will. I said, God will. I said, God will.
Bring me through. Are you ready for this? Are you ready to believe? Don't let the devil deceive you. Let him tell you you can't. You gotta say to that devil, "I believe I can." Yes. If you believe you can, I'm gonna let you know God will. Take care of it. I must believe God can do it. You must believe that God can use you to do it. 2018, you gotta believe like that little engine. You know, the train may be heavy, but with God on my side, I can do it. You gotta face some challenges this year, but believe I can do it. With God on my side, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Are you ready for this? You're facing some challenges this year, but you must believe that you can. Come on, give God the praise in this house today. Believe that you can. Believe that. Don't be deceived. Believe in God. Believe in yourself. Believe God for your family. Believe God for your community. Believe God for your children. Believe God for your church.
Yes,
Lord. You got it? If you believe, all things are possible to all those who believe. The sword said, "Yes, I believe." Like the little engine, he believed he could carry the load of that train. God sees the load you gotta carry. God sees what's on the track. But because you connected to the Lord, and you're connected to God, it wasn't the little engine doing it all by himself, but it was God pushing that engine. You're not gonna be able to make it by yourself in 2018, but because God lives it. And the Spirit dwells. you to make it over the hill, down in the valley, and throughout the community. God wants you to believe. If you believe, I'm going to tell you, you shall receive. Give God the praise.